Yeah, good morning, everybody. Oh, how come? I don't have that one. Okay. So, welcome to the class of electronic circuits 1. So, we'll use mostly English. But if you ask a question in Korean, I will ask in Korean. Okay? How come I cannot write it down? Uh-oh. I got some problem. What happened? Oh yeah, now I try. Oh yeah. Okay. Oh, can you read this? Huh? So actually, we'll use this Chinese character. And English. In question, you can ask a question in Korean. I will answer in Korean. Okay? But Chinese character, Chinese character is more and more important nowadays. Because, the importance of Far East Asia is being important, right? China, Japan, Korea, Taiwan. So if you go around this Far East area, Chinese character is very convenient, right? So if you can read Chinese character, if you can speak Chinese, you will be very, I mean, your price will go up. So, yeah, so mostly English, some Chinese character. You can answer, I mean, ask a question in Korean. All right? So, yeah, so this is a syllabus. The first lecture is late in uploading it. You can find it analog.postec.ac.kr. Go to lecture and then electronic circuits 1. You will find the PDF of next class. All right. So this class is a homework-oriented class. Homework. Homework is very important. Homework is, see, this is actually house. See. This is people. 100 people live in the house. So this is kind of. So you can find this homework. Yeah. So we have four homeworks, four quiz. All the quiz will be mostly from homeworks. Slight changes. Okay? Yeah, so this class is tightly coupled with basic experiments on electronics. Okay? So, you are recommended to take those two classes together.기초전자실험. That's a basic experiment, right? 기초전자실험. This one. So we'll have a first meeting of this class at 6:30 p.m. today at this room. So today you find your partner, lab partner, okay, two people in a team. All right? So by 6:30 you find a lab partner Yeah, grading. Grading, we have four quiz and we have four homeworks. So actually, we have some class presence 10%. Yeah, that homework will be some discussion session. This homework is supposed to be submitted on a quiz day, before quiz. Yeah, the first part, it's divided into four parts. The first part is review of circuit theory, RLC element, amplifier, op-amp, Laplace transform, equivalent circuit, LC resonance, frequency response, 2.5 weeks. And there will be one homework and one quiz. Okay, second part is PN junction diode, rectifier, clamp circuit, DC-DC converter, 4 weeks. One homework and one quiz. Okay, third part is bipolar junction transistor circuit, common emitter, common base, common collector, this single transistor amplifier, and bias circuit, 3.5 weeks. The last part is MOSFET. MOSFET device, amplifier, common source, common gate, common drain, those single transistor amplifier, frequency response, switch, differential pair, digital circuit, 5 weeks. Okay? So this lab, basic experiment, so you are supposed to come to this room 6:30 p.m. every week. Okay? There will be pre-report for this lab. And there is a simple quiz. Yeah, this notice, please do not sit in the last 4 rows. So you just come forward. So if you wanna go out of classroom during class hours, ask permission first. Okay? Question. Oh, this lab. So actually, this is a different class, eh? This is not electronic circuit one. Yeah, that quiz will be included as a part of a grading system. Okay, any other question? Yeah. Yeah. Every homework and every quiz. Okay. Four quiz. So some people may feel comfortable about that because every step they just finish it, forget about that, and go on. Okay, any other question? No? Yeah. Quiz is exam, same thing. Okay, let's go to the main topic, terminology. So we'll use the Chinese character and the English and Korean. Okay, actually, the electronic circuit is a concept. I mean, the most important one is a concept, right? Not calculation. So we'll talk about the mostly concept. All right. What's an electronic circuit? Electronic circuit is there are two things here. One is electron. Actually, this is electron circuit. Yeah, so this is a circuit for electrons, right? So let's talk about the electron first. So in physics, you know about the atom, right? There is a big atom. This atom composed of proton and neutron, right? Proton positive charge, neutron just a neutral charge. And then there is small electrons circling around this atom, right? circling around this atom. Those are electrons. So electronic circuit deals with the electron. So those electrons. We don't deal about the atom, right? So electronic circuit is a circuit for electrons. So let's talk about the electron first. Electron is, let me see. Electron is electron. In a Chinese character, it said, yeah, that's electron. So, you know, this one is okay, this is just rain, right? Say this part is actually lightning. Okay, actually this rain and lightning, they combine together. It's just lightning. So you know this is only sun, right? So electron is nothing but son of lightning. Oh yeah, son of lightning. You know lightning, right? This is my lightning. Okay. Oh, electron is, see, there must be some electron flow in the lightning, right? So electron is just a son of lightning. Actually, Chinese character, they have a very good translation, right? Sometimes Korean and Japan, they are very, very poor. Sometimes very poor in translation. But Chinese character, they have a better translation. You know, it makes sense, right? Son of lightning. Oh, that's an electron. All right. Let's talk about the circuit. What's a circuit? Circuit is in Chinese character. This is coming back. And this is actually road. So, you know, this where means it comes back to the same place, okay? Say this is a starting point and then ending point are the same. This way is going around. This road is just road, right? Road. Actually, this is a foot. Okay, foot. Actually, this is a foot, right? This slightly changed the form, but it's a foot. So actually, this foot. This means actually this is Ichi-foot. Ichi-foot means it's a road that we go to the road by foot, right? So in English, it's a circuit. This circuit means see. Do I have a circuit here? Oh yeah, next thing. This CIR means circle. Okay, this comes from circle. So circuit means some structure like a circle. Okay, so electron goes around this path and then come back to the same place. Starting point and the end point are the same. That's a circle. Circuit is the same. Okay. So electronic circuit is a closed path. This is a circle. Closed path of electron flow. That's a circuit. So in other area of engineering, there is some terminology circuit. Their circuit is slightly different from our circuit, but the common thing is it forms a circle. The starting point and end point are the same. Okay, that's a circuit, right? Say, for example, Yeah, in this is a Korean map, right? We are here. Say, if you go to from Pohang, Seoul, Gwangju, Busan, and come back to Pohang again, so it is also a circuit if you go around. Okay. Yeah, lightning. So this is a lightning, right? This is lightning. Say, if I add rain here, because after lightning, we mostly have rain. Yeah, this is also, right? It looks like rain, right? Yeah, this is rain. Okay. This rain combined with this lightning makes this lightning. Actually, see, where is the character? Oh, okay. So, you know, I think you. At least you should be able to write your name of your school and name of your department in Chinese character. Okay? Yeah, see, this one, let me see. Yeah, this is actually, if you remember each component, then this is water, right? Water. Water can write in many different ways, eh? But this is water. And then this is wide water means okay. So what's this Han? You can see this kind of character a lot, I mean this part. So if I combine Gong here, yeah, this is yeah, and Gong. This is actually you know what this one, right? Rice crop. And this is some sort of this is this is guamokwa. So you should be able to write the Chinese character rather easily of this part. Okay? You may come across this one at the quiz. Okay, any question until now? No? Okay, let's go quickly. So, what's the lightning? You know, this is my earth. And then there is a cloud. This is my cloud. Yeah, this is my cloud, right? Then, this cloud, I mean, in some by some physical operation, say there is a upper portion of cloud is charged with a positive charge. This lower part of a cloud is charged with some negative charges. Okay, charges are separated by some physical operation. And then those negative charges will push positive charge inside the Earth. And then, oh, sorry, negative charge. And then this Earth's surface is induced with a positive charges, then there will be electric field, right? Electric field. If this electric field happen to be very large, so there is a electron flow across this air, right? That's lightning. Okay, sometimes you will see very bright light. See, actually, very bright light. Wow, this is very bright. This is very heavy, very high intensity electron flow between cloud and earth to discharge those accumulated charges, right? That's lightning. Okay? I don't know why they put it like that. Oh, this is my lightning. You can see, oh, there may be some bombs, right? Sometimes it looks like that. Sometimes it looks just like a very deep blow. That's lightning. So in this lightning, there are a lot of electrons, right? Electrons, see, flowing from cloud to earth, right? Electron flow during this lightning. Actually, in the lightning, we hear some thunder. Thunder. And thunder is, see, again, this is rain, BU. Actually, what is this thing? So this is actually ray. So this is a sound. Lightning is just light. Yeah, let's go to the Western origin of etymology of electron. So, this is related to static electricity. Say this is amber, amber. What amber is? Yeah, this is amber. Okay. So, in Jurassic Park, there is a little mosquito here, right? Mosquito. So they inside this amber. Scientists took out some blood of this very ancient mosquito. Oh, there was some DNA of dinosaurs, right? Dinosaurs. And then made a Jurassic Park. This is only movie story. Eh? So that amber is, yeah, this is a kind of precious stone. So if you rub it, there is a static electricity. Okay? That from that static electricity, so actually in the Greek, they call amber electron. Okay? So in the Western side, that static electricity is the origin of electron. Okay? Yeah, there are many terminology related to this okay. So charge. What's charge? Charge is charge. Eh? Actually, this is ka. It too makes a ha. Okay, charge. This is kind of load. Oh, sorry. There must be this is a plant. So if I combine this plant and man and this possible God. allowed. So it's a load, actually load. You can see 하중 부하, that's a load, right? So that's some electron load. They call it. So this charge is accumulation of electrons. Electrons are accumulated somewhere. It forms a charge. So this potential is actually it's this is a man's standing position. Actually, this is some position of electron. Position means so it's you know there is some potential difference, and then there is some electric field, right? That's a potential. This voltage is similar to potential, right? Pressure. There is a pressure, right? This is my pressure. You know, this is a dog, right? Dog. I forgot this name. This is V. Stomach or something like that. Stomach. Okay, anyway, this is a pressure. Electron pressure. Okay, electron pressure. That's a potential difference. That's an electron flow, current. Current. This is a water and something like that. This is a flow, actually. Water flow. So this is the flow of electron. And then how about the electricity? This is some energy, right? Energy. So you can see this is only, you can find this me a lot of places, okay? Very popular component of Chinese character. So this is electricity is actually electron energy. Yeah, this is some magnetic energy. Magnetic energy. Yeah. So this qi is energy. Okay, how about the ge? K is a field, field. You can see this ge, 세계, 경계, 세계. Okay, this ge is a field. 전계, electric field. There is E field, magnetic field. Some field, This is related to some potential, right? This one is induced by current flow. Yeah, simple review. So those electric field is related to the charge. Okay, charge generates electric field, Gauss law. Okay, if there is a closed space, I have a Q inside this closed space. If I integrate all the electric field coming out of this surface of this closed object, that's Q, right? By Gauss law, charge generates electric field. So it will induce potential difference. Right? This potential difference nothing but this just electric field. Charge generates electric field. Electric field induces potential difference. Yeah, similarly, if I have a current flow I around along this conductor, it will generate a magnetic field H, right? So if I integrate this magnetic field around this path, around this path, see, this should be current inside this circle. If I go around the H, integrate H field along a circle, should be current flowing through that circle. Okay? Yeah, see, H will generate the magnetic flux, right? B equal mu H. Say, sorry, this is a magnetic field. The magnetic flux is the integration of B. Then, Faraday law will state this potential difference will generate some potential difference. So there is a relation between magnetic field and the electric field by the Faraday law. Okay? Okay, any question? Yeah, this is the end of introduction. Let's go to more main topic. So we'll talk about the basic circuits, basic. RLC, diode, transistor, integrated circuit, very large scale integration, signals, frequency spectrum, analog signal, digital signal, amplifier, small signal equivalent circuit, and frequency response and sigma space. So you are supposed to use this sigma space in a lab and also in the homework. Well, homework. As we said, this class is a homework-oriented class. Homework is the most important. I mean, after quiz. Quiz has more portion, right? So the first homework due is already in 2 weeks. Yeah, late penalty is very severe. Okay, late penalty. If you submit the homework. Oh, actually, yeah, in 5 days, no credit, right? Homework is 30% of total grading system. Yeah, we'll have a discussion session. So you can ask question about the homeworks. But this is only 1 day earlier. Maybe we can make it a little bit earlier. So this is a tentative. Okay, question. No, in the evening. We'll have a quiz and discussion session in the evening. Do you have lab on Tuesday, right? Lab. Monday, we have a basic electronic circuit lab. Wednesday evening, do you have a lab on Wednesday evening? No? So this is some microprocessor lab on Tuesday. So how about the Thursday? No lab? Oh, lab. Somebody has a lab. How about the Friday? No labs. Oh yeah, we have 2 days in a week. In the evening. Okay, so this is actually homework. Yeah, similar to last year. So we have some signal. Oh yeah, this signal is this is a man's word is believable. So you can believe a man's word, right? Oh, it makes sense, right? That's a middle sign. Ho, 그렇죠. I think this is some sort of, yeah, actually, this is related to tiger, 호랑이 호. So actually, this is some sort of sound or something, okay? Some signal, okay? Anyway, this signal is a signal. It must contain information. So it's kind of irregular. If you record a human voice, it's something like that. There is some burst and then quiet, burst and quiet. So there is some irregular pattern. That's the usual form of a signal. Okay, anyway, in a signal source, you can see your function generator or whatever. Signal source can be represented by this. So this is a waveform. So this is called a waveform. This is called a 파형 waveform. Let's see. Something like that. What's inside? I think this is not this one. This part, I'm not sure. Okay. Anyway, this waveform means some time domain representation of a signal. That's called a waveform. If I represent this one in the frequency domain, I can represent this one in the frequency domain also the same thing. That's a spectrum. So there is a direct relationship between waveform and this frequency spectrum. There is a Fourier transform, sometimes a Laplace transform. Okay? There is a one-to-one correspondence. Anyway, function generator. Actually, this one is a poor translation. In Korean, function is this is a function, right? Say for this is a function. For any x, I have a y. Yeah, this is a function. So actually, this function generator is not this 함수. This is some sort of the function generator, not 함수 발생기. It's some sort of operation. Okay. So anyway, we call function generator is modeled by ideal voltage source with a source resistance. Any signal can be modeled by that. Sometimes this RS is nonlinear. This one is linear. I mean, voltage across this one and current across this one is linear, right? Because RS is a constant. Sometimes RS can be nonlinear, not linear. See, this is VS, IS is, this is linear, right? Sometimes it's not. Generally, it can be something like that or whatever. Sometimes it can be something like that. Actually, this is a diode, it's a green one. So RS can be nonlinear, but mostly we just approximate function generator, linear source resistance, and then ideal voltage source. See, I have a 10 sine omega t, amplitude is 10 volt. Eh? And then, see, if I don't attach anything, I have a 10 volt output. Say, if this RS is usually 50 ohm in a function generator, if I attach 50 ohm load here, I have only 5 volt sine wave here, right? So, yeah, this is to identify the role of this source resistance for the first one, okay? Thevenin, you already know that because, you know, this chapter is a review of basic circuit theory, Thevenin. So, okay, we go over that one one by one. What's this thing? Linear time invariant system. Linear time invariant system. And then, yeah, some frequency response. And what's this thing? Yeah, there is some energy storage element, inductor and capacitor. R does not save energy, but inductor and capacitor save. This saves electric energy. This saves magnetic energy, right? Something like that. Nonlinear circuit, some resonance circuit. Yeah, so you will be get familiar with the SPICE netlist very quickly, right? If you once go over homework. Unit. Concept. Superposition principle. Linear time invariant system. Yeah, it's a linear superposition principle holds. Okay. Yeah, filter. Oh, there are some reading assignment also, right? So I'm not sure about this page, but you will find this title in your text. Just review in one page. Okay? Ideal op-amp. Yeah, this is a silent key filter, second order, because I have two energy storage element. This is ideal op-amp. Yeah, ideal op-amp, see negative feedback. There is a virtual ground here, right? Negative feedback. It should be negative feedback, right? Virtual ground. Virtual ground means the input voltage is zero. The input voltage between two input nodes. Okay, any question about the homeworks? No? Huh? This is just this 12 problem is homework number one. You will have one review session before quiz. So most of quiz will come based on this homework with some slight changes. Oh no. Korean is okay. Because in this homework, say you can do it in Korean. No problem. You can do it in English. Okay. Yeah, let's start the real main topic. So we'll review basic elements. Electronic device. Yeah, electron. We talked about the electron. What's a device? Device is a simple thing. Yeah, actually, it's similar to this one, right? And actually, this one is. Oh yeah, this is the owner of this shield string. So it should be very simple. Okay. This is this is a simple one. So this should be very simple component, right? Simple component. So this is a very small and simple structure. That's a device. Not very complex. So, actually, this is so simple electronic device includes resistor, inductor, capacitor, diode, transistor. Oh, this IC and VLSI is not very simple, right? But we sometimes put op-amp is a device, right? We sometimes put CPU chip is a device. We can extend the concept. Yeah, resistor. What's a resistor? Oh, resistor is something resist current flow. Yeah, this thing does not want current flow. Actually, you can see this is actually hand. Eh? The one, this is so this means you just put your hand below. So it's kind of defense, okay? So this is a kind of defense because you put your hand below your stomach, something like that. Somebody wants to hit you with a stick. So you wanna defend yourself by raising by putting by positioning your hand below belt maybe. And then this thing is hang is this is again your hand. This is actually you place your hand with a in a high position. So you want to resist it. This is a kind of defense. You resist by raising your hand upward. Okay. So anyway, this 저항 it resists some change. So resist is element which resists current flow. Okay. If I have a large resistance, I have a small current flow. Famous law. Yeah, Ohm's law. Say I have a resistor here, and then I apply voltage V, and I have a current I. The relation is just a simple linear relation. That's Ohm's law, right? If I have a large resistance, this is larger R, right? Oh, sorry, this is a small r. Small r. Yeah, we have Ohm's law in the resistor. So you already know the current. So you have to remember that. So black is zero. Say in a color band, see, I have something like that. Oh, this is what? This looks like a green. Green is a 6 or something. Oh, sorry, green is a 5. Blue is a 6. And this is yellow is a 4. Oh, I have a 5, 6, 4 here, which means 56 times 10 to the 4 ohm. Okay? It's a color band, right? So it's a 560 K ohm. So you should get familiar with the color band, all right? So this is actually this is gold. Gold is error, 5% error, gold. Sometimes I have a more band. Say this is a 4 band. Say this is 2, 3. What's this? 7? Yeah, here is 7, 0. Oh, this is what? Oh, this is even tighter. What's this thing? Silver. Silver is 10%, right? So this is 1%. What's 1%? Okay, so 2370. I have a 4 band, so it's if I have that one, this is 10 to the 0. Oh, this is only 270. So this is error band. Yeah, you will see two kinds of resistors. Sometimes 4 band, sometimes 5 band, 5 color band. Yeah, recently we have some sort of cheap resistor, very small one. We wanna reduce the circuit size as much as possible. The resistance size is also very small, so it's something like this one. This does not have any color band. Instead, it has some numbers on it. Okay, so those are metal bars, very small one. Smaller inductance associated with it. All right, let's remember this one. Black is zero. Actually, I don't know. See, I remembered this color band by this one. 흑, 갈, 적, 등, 황, 녹, 청, 자, 회, 백. So if I wanna know what's blue, I have to go all over this one. 흑, 갈, 적, 등, 황, 녹. Oh, 녹 means five. Well, I don't know how you remember this one in one way or another. So I want you memorize this color band. Okay? green is 5, yellow is 4, orange is 3, orange 등. This is orange. Red is 2, violet 7. 자, gray 8, white 9, white is 9. 오, yeah, I have even six band one is here. Oh, what's a six band one? Oh, this looks orange, right? Three, is this seven? Violet, seven. This is six, right? Zero. Oh, those are. Oh, this is not red, not orange. Red, 2, 7, 6, 5%. So the last thing is a temperature coefficient, right? Temperature coefficient. Yeah, this is 4602. What's this thing? 460 times 10 to the 2. Is this true? No, this is 3. 3. 460K. Because this is orange. And then this is gold. Gold 1%. Is this true? Actually, this part I cannot identify that error band. So this is your tolerance is silver 10%, gold 5%. There is I don't know this color 1%. There are some other tolerance error and temperature coefficient. This is for 6 band one. Temperature 10 ppm. ppm is a parts per million. Parts per million. Okay. Temperature coefficient. Question. 레지스턴스. 레지스턴스 just dissipate the energy. Does not store anything. Or it just dissipate the energy as a heat. Okay? Yeah, capacitor. Capacitor saves, stores electric field as in form of energy. Okay? So capacitor, this capacitor. Say it said it stores. This is storage of it just stores. This is kind of lake pond. It just stores electron in a pond. Okay. So capacitor several forms. This is electrolyte capacitor, and this is some sort of ceramic capacitor, and those are some cheap capacitors. And there are many other forms of capacitors. Yeah, very simple form of energy is just a parallel plate capacitor. How come? Did I put anything? Oh yeah, this thing. Oh yeah, it comes back. So parallel metal plate capacitor. I have two parallel metal. So this is my metal plate. And I have another metal plate here. Another metal plate. See, if there is a electric field, say if I have a charge here, there must be the same amount of charge stored in the opposite side, and then I will have electric field, right? So if this distance is d between two metal plate, and if this area is a, yeah. I can find from Gauss law. See, the capacitance is defined to be the charge divided by potential difference between two. That's the definition of capacitance, right? If I have a large capacitor, I can collect large charges for a given V. So I can derive a capacitance here by using Gauss law. Say, the electric field, there is an electric field here. However, Electric field is zero outside of those two plates because, you know, here, see from Gauss law, the net charge is zero inside here, so electric field must be zero outside region. So in between, say if I have a area something like that, say you can see, then just something like that. I have electric field here, I have Q there, E equals 0 there, and then see, if I have apply Gauss law here, there is a minus Q there. So, you know, this is epsilon. Gauss law says, right? So my electric field here is just epsilon over Q. Actually, say I had to derive this one by A or something. This is a kind of normalization. So what's V? V is just E times D, right? So this is epsilon A over DQ. So my C happened to be Q divided by V. This is epsilon A over D. Okay, that's my capacitance, right? The capacitance is the capability of keeping charges for a given potential V. Now, there are some other forms of capacitors. See, if you see 103J, it means similar to resistor. You can find this one, in some numbers here. Those here, see, you can see this ceramic capacitor, it says this is 103J. Yeah, it's this 10 times 10 to the 3 times this is error bound. This is picofarad, right? So this is 10 to the 4 picofarad, which is 10 nanofarad, okay? J is error bound is plus minus 5%. Gauss law, or Gauss lived in 19th century. He was so famous, he became model of German money. So this is Gauss law, okay? He was a mathematician and also a physicist. So he derived the electric field is generated by charge. Okay, let's talk about the displacement current. This terminology, I think you know, this displacement current. This is a current, but it was wrong placed current. This. The current position was mistaken. Okay, so I have signal waveform here, and then I have some element, maybe resistor or whatever, and I have a capacitor here, say, yeah, this may be resistor or whatever. Anyway, let's just see. So current is electron flow, right? Current is a flow of electron. So in a conductor, there should be some current flowing, but in here, say there is some QT, minus QT here. In between, there is no current flow. I mean, no electron can flow from this electrode to that electrode, right? Actually, there is no current in between. So I equals zero in between, all right? However, then in this case, my KCL doesn't work. Kirchhoff current law doesn't work because see, there is no current. If I assume a fake current, which is a displacement current here, so I can assume my current here Then I have my KCL works. Alright? That's a displacement current. So between capacitor, there is no electron flow. There is no current flow. However, if I assume a displacement current, IT, which is dQ over dt. Yeah, this is C dV over dt. Because if C is a constant, because my QT is C times V, right? If C is a constant for the linear capacitor. So if I assume a displacement current, because the current does not flow in between, current flow here. So then I have my KCL works, right? Through capacitor. Okay, any question? No? So, impedance of capacitor. Yeah, impedance can be written as just voltage drop across device and the current through a device. So, in a linear capacitor, something like that. So here you can see this capacitance, I mean impedance of a capacitor changes with the time. For the DC signal, yeah, my voltage does not change, current is zero, okay? Because voltage and charge does not change with the time, so there shouldn't be any current flow. Then this is infinite, right, for DC. So capacitor is open circuit at the DC. But very fast changing signal, this impedance is can be small. So very high frequency signal, the impedance of capacitance becomes very small. Yeah, what's the energy stored in the capacitor? Yeah, see, if I don't have any charge in this parallel plate metal plate, then voltage drop is also zero because my E field is zero, voltage drop is potential difference is zero, there shouldn't be any energy. Energy should be, electric energy is zero. Say, if I place a Q1, a small Q1, and then if I add a small Q1 here, there will be minus Q1 will be developed at the other plate. Then, how much work did I do? See, actually this work is, we can write it Q times V, okay? See, because I added a Q1 here, there is some potential drop. So here, let's just see. If this is, there is some electric field. If I move some to collect this Q1 across this electric field, this is my energy. You can derive it. Work equal Q times V. Okay, so this is Q is CV, C times dV. This is actually dQ. So if I integrate this one, I can get come across energy of this one is 1/2 CV square. Okay, that's the electric energy. Yeah, until now, we have for the capacitor, capacitor equal the operation is can be written by this equation, but for the linear capacitor, Q equal constant C times V, so my IT is a constant C times dV, DT. Similarly, I can say QT equal integration T. If I integrate all the current flow, should be the charge, stored charge. Okay? Yeah, let's look at the review, the operation of simple RC circuit. So this is 1 volt, for example, 1 volt, 0 volt. For T negative. So this voltage Vs remains at zero all the time, right? If this is 0 volt, say sometimes we can put some ground here for convenience. So if this is zero, then any charge, see, if there happen to be any charge Q here, it will flow like that, right? Eventually QT goes to zero. Because I kept this voltage zero for a long time, so my VOT should be zero at the T equals zero. Because it's discharged, right? Capacitor will be discharged by resistor. If this is zero, VS equals zero, if you assume this is a some volt V, then you know, this volt should be V, right? Then, you know, there must be current flow, I equal V over R, right? So I cannot, this QT cannot be sustained because, you know, because of this current flow, this Q will be reduced, right? Eventually, it will go to zero if Vs equal zero for a long time. Okay? So we can accept this initial condition, capacitor voltage zero at the T equals zero. Okay, what happens if this my Vs becomes V? This is my Vs for T equal positive. So then R and C here. Then for T equals zero positive, T equals zero positive, this charge is zero because this charge is zero also, right? Because the charge is integration of current flow, right? This I can say zero. So, for the finite current, this QT must be continuous with the time. At the T equals 0 negative, QT is 0. T equals 0 positive, QT is also 0. This is VOT is 0. Okay? Then, voltage drop across resistor is V because of KVL. So, there is a large current flow, which is V of R flows through capacitor, so it will increase those charge amount, right? So because the current is flowing through that, there is a negative charge developed at the opposite side, right? So current flow is something like zero. This is my current, and then at the T equals zero, this current becomes V of R, right? Then there will be some charge will be accumulated, the voltage will be developed. The voltage across this one is V minus VO because I have a finite V, current will be reduced, right? It will be reduced, something like that. And then how about the charge? Charge will be developed. Charge will be developed. This is zero, and then charge will be developed, and then it goes to where? C times V, right? This V. And then if this becomes V, and this resistance voltage becomes 0, and then current becomes 0, yeah, current goes to 0. So no more change, right? So my VOT will change, my VOT will change similar to that, right? This V. Yeah, what's the energy stored in this capacitor? Yeah, energy stored in the capacitor will be something like power, I times V dt. Or you can say this is some sort of dq times V, V times dq or whatever. They will be the same. Because I dt is just dq, okay? It dq, something like that. What's the energy stored in this process? So actually we need some sort of relation. Then my IT, you can say this is V of R exponential minus T of RC for T positive. And then what's my V? Yeah, my V will be, I can say this is 1 minus, this is V, 1 minus exponential minus T of RC. We can derive like that. So if you substitute those two, my energy will be half CV square. You can find it eventually. Question? Nope. Just review. You can ask any question. Question welcomed. No? I think this is about time, right? 10:45. 9:30, yeah. Okay, if there is no question, let's start here.